अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट, टुडे विल स्टार्ट विद द लास्ट चैप्टर ऑफ ज्योग्राफी, दैट इज़ टूरिज्म। सी, टूरिज्म इज़ नाउ यू नो वेरी मच इन डिमांड एंड पीपल ट्रैवल फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अनदर। इट्स लाइक एवरी वन डिसाइड देयर हॉलीडे, देयर डेस्टिनेशंस टू ट्रैवल फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अनदर। सो दिस इज़ यू नो द थिंग दैट people are, you know, the tourism is getting in the popular, they are getting popular, or it is getting popular. Many of the, you know, travel agents, travel facilities are including, we can go to the historical places, hill stations, and different, you know, countries very easily because of the tourism is getting so popular. Now let's start with the chapter. We undertake short or long journeys for various purposes like festivals, family functions, fairs, sports, wandering, recreations, etc. We need to carry out some preparation before going anywhere, such as selecting the route to go there, choose the mess of the means of the transport, packing essential things, etc. When we reach the destination, we visit to an exide and spectral site. Sometimes we stay there. We make use of the facilities provided over there. We also pay in lieu of these service or goods. Visiting various places away our home for getting joy, entertainment, trading, staying, etc. It's called tourism. So basically it is explained that what is tourism? Tourism is something like you can go for various reasons, whether it's about your, you know, somewhere your wedding functions are there or any other functions is there. So you want to travel from, you know, one place to another. Maybe you have to trade between different states, different countries, states, or, you know, these things. Then, you know, recreation sports. If you are, you know, good in sports and you have to play in the national level or international level, you have to, you know, travel from one place to another. Then what is the packing essential? What is you need? What you needed in your traveling in your, you know, one place you are, if you are going from one place to another, the traveling essentials you need. Then where you going to stay, or at what purpose you are going, like for entertainment, trading, or staying. So these all comes in tourism. Now see the India map. Then the place given on the map have some famous due to different reasons. Some special things are reason behind the place becoming famous. For example, natural beauty, pleasant weather, scenery, hot spring, sea coast, historical moments, religious places, forest areas, etc. are major attractions for tourists. On the basis of political boundary, tourism can be into two types. See, now the places where we are going, if you will see the example of India, there are, you know, 29 states and they are popular for their own goodness or maybe their own things they are popular for. If you will see, you will taking Ajmer, they are popular for their Dargah. Then if you are taking Delhi is, you know, before that it was popular for India Gate, then Metro, and these are the things. If you will take the Mumbai, the basic people, people get attracted because of sea, Bollywood and all. Then the South, their literacy rate is high. They have lots of, you know, sea. And if you'll see Lucknow, they are very popular for their, you know, language. So these are, you know, the different states which are popular for their different purpose. Now the tourism is, you know, divided into the political boundaries. So they are divided into domestic tourism and international tourism. First is domestic tourism. Tourism within the limits of country is called domestic tourism. For example, a person from Maharashtra going to the Kanyakumari in the Tamil Nadu for the tourists. A person from Nagpur visiting aloe vera caves in Aurangabad, etc. See, domestic tourism is you are traveling from inside or in India only. Within India, you are traveling from one place to another. If I'm going from Mumbai to Kashmir, that will come into the domestic tourism. If you are traveling from Kolkata to Kanyakumari, that also comes in domestic tourism. Now the international and the foreign tourism. Crossing countries boundary and visiting some other country for tourists is called international tourism. For example, an India going to the Switzerland for tourists, an American coming in from India for tourists, etc. Tourism, sorry. So what is international traveling? That you are crossing India. We are Indians and we are crossing India. That will called as foreign tourism, or you can say as international tourism, because you are going out from your country. If you are going even to Pakistan and even Sri Lanka, that's also counted for international tour or foreign tour. See, some of the, you know, pictures are given, which is, you know, popular for their tourism. On the basis of aim of tourists and the specialties of the destination, there can be different types of tourism. Some of these have been explained through photographs. From the above, we infer the tourism is very important for country. Basic facilities should be developed at the place which have been developed as a tourist site mainly. Domestic tourism should be promoted. It is necessary to preserve the culture heritage of the country. See, now what is, you know, basic things of the... If something is popular, for example, Mumbai is popular for Bollywood, their seas and all. So they have to be, you know, maintain that image, because to attract the tourism. For example, their seas should be very neat and clean. They have to, you know, pay attention on Gateway of India. There is, you know, the place they can visit. If they are going Agra and they are seeing at the Taj Mahal should be in that position to ask for money, because we charge there. If you are, you know, visiting to any park in the Mumbai, that park should be very clean, and they should not charge a lot money to them. So these are the things we have to keep into the considerations. See, these are the pictures for attract the tourism. Then tourism is an important territory occupation. Through this occupation, the wood gets introduced to the region's natural, social, cultural environments. Besides domestic tourists, foreign tourists also visit various places of interest, and therefore foreign currency increase in our economy. Along with these benefits, development of tourist place, availability of employment opportunity to the local people are also good things that happen to place. Considering the importance of tourism, the local residents become aware of conversing the region's natural beauty and culture. Tourism should be promoted through the advertisement in various media, which is help in the growth. See, now what happened? Tourism will give you the occupation also. If you'll see the example of Kashmir, what happened? Their natural beauty, their local bodies, they'll get occupation through tourism. If the tourists will visit there, that all the shikarawalas and the houseboats and the art, which is, you know, very popular in Kashmir, can easily be sold out, and this will increase their economy, even their occupation. They'll get the number of occupation to attract the tourism, and plus the Indian currency will going to improve their economic value. Why? Because people are visiting to Kashmir just to get attracted by their natural beauty or their, you know, their art, and this will come, you know, this will increase the national economy. So these are the things they will give you. Even the guides are there who will guide you. This is the place, it was popular from 90s or maybe the 60s or maybe the 70s. The even in the park, these flowers are for this purpose and that purpose. So this is, you know, improve the occupation and the employment opportunities. Now, various forms of tourism are emerging to give a flip to tourism. One of these is ecotourism. This concept came into the light when it was realized that due to increased population, pollution and urbanization, environment is degrading in an eco-friendly type of tourism. If tourism developed by the considering that the while touring a place, the environment should not be regarded or damaged by the tourists, then it is called as ecotourism. This includes taking precaution on not throwing litter at tourist sites, avoiding noise pollution, not hurting trees and birds and animals in the forest. Besides these, recently a concept of agrotourism has arisen, which is a pollution free location away from the city, holding an agriculture activity where the tourist is shown as a glimpse of the agricultural life. Tourists are attracted towards it. This is called as a agrotourism. For a change from the urban life, tourists leave on the farm and accept the hospitality of the farmers on the payment in the agrotourism. In Pune and Kolhapur district of Maharashtra, number of agrotourism centers have been developed. Now one more thing is, the tourism should be eco-friendly. That means the tourists should not harm or dirty that place of tourists. For example, if you are going to see the cave, so you cannot throw your damage and the wastage there. You cannot litter there. Why? Because that is a place you can visit, or it is for tourists. You know, you have to take the precaution while, you know, visiting this place. If you'll see the example of Mahabaleshwar, what happened? That is the agrotourism. That means you can go to the strawberry farm, and you can see how it is processed, how, you know, you can get that strawberries from there. And this will, you know, improve the quality and the life of the farmers also. So these come that we have to take care of that sites which we are visiting as a tourist place, and we have to be very eco-friendly. We cannot shout there. We cannot, you know, harm the birds by clicking pictures or animals. If you are going to the zoo, you cannot continuously, you know, clicking the pictures, because their flashlight can harm them. So these are the precautions we have to take it. Film tourism is a new type of tourism. The location where films are not shot attract the crowd of tourists, and hence the concept of film tourism emerged. A number of amenities and the facilities are provided to attract the tourists to these places where film shooting take place. Example, Mumbai Film City, Ramuji Film City. Tarkali in the Kokan is the famous for the seed and the biodiversity is found there. Here the tourists can do the scorn killing and the scuba diving. MTDH has started the scuba diving training center of international standards, Tarkali. See, now what happened after that agro and eco tourism, we have this film tourism also. That means you can go to different kind of film cities, that is Ramuji Film City in Hyderabad and Mumbai Film City is in Bombay. So these are the film city which gives you a look how the film has been made, or how it is, you know, they entertain the public or private people, that how the film, you know, make, or what are the process behind that. So these comes, you know, the film tourism. We'll see till here. Next we'll continue in next lecture. Thank you.